Hi, my name is Ludia Pack, and you are watching the University of Rochester Pathology video series. Today's video is on the basic histology of the cervix, which can be seen using virtual slide H164. The cervix is a part of the female reproductive system located between the uterus and the vagina. The cervix is made up of epithelium and underlying stroma. It is normally between 1 to 2 centimeters in length. Sperm passes through the cervical canal to the uterus, where it may or may not be able to fertilize an egg. The length of this canal varies in length or width throughout a woman's lifetime. At its widest, the cervical canal measures 8 millimeters in diameter. The side that opens up into the uterus is called the internal os, and the opening that faces the vagina is called the external os. This is a cross-section of the cervix. There are two major areas, the ectocervix and the endocervix. The ectocervix is a part of the cervix that bulges into the superior portion of the vaginal vault. The size and shape of this region varies depending on the woman's age. The endocervix is a term given to the mucosa lining the cervical canal. Most of the cervix consists of fibromuscular tissue, and the epithelium is either squamous or columnar. Here is a close-up view of the ectocervix. The ectocervix is on average 3 centimeters long and 2.5 centimeters wide. The ectocervix is lined with non-keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium. There are four layers, the basal layer which includes basal or reserve cells, the parabasal layer, the intermediate layer, and the superficial cell layer. The basal layer contains a single layer of cuboidal cells with minimal cytoplasm and round or oval nuclei. Right above the basal cells are parabasal cells, which are round or oval-shaped cells with a dense cytoplasm. These cells are not usually found in women who are producing estrogen. Above this lies the intermediate layer, which consists of polygonal-shaped intermediate-sized cells. These cells have a thin, transparent cytoplasm that stains basophilic with a smaller nucleus. And the outermost layer is the superficial layer. These cells are flat, eosinophilic, and polygonal in shape. The superficial layer can vary in thickness based on the amount of estrogen stimulation. Here is a close-up view of the endocervix. The endocervix is lined by columnar epithelium, which secretes mucus. The endocervical mucosa is about 3 millimeters thick. The epithelium has infoldings that cause it to look like glands in cross-section. Surrounding the columnar cells lies the dense stroma. Another feature of the cervix is the squamo-columnar junction, or SCJ, which is the area where the squamous and columnar epithelium meet. This location can migrate as columnar epithelium is replaced by squamous epithelium. At birth, the SCJ is located closer to the external os, but shifts depending on the woman's age and estrogen production. In teenagers, the SCJ is in the ectocervix, but moves higher up the cervical canal in older women. As the SCJ shifts, the area between the old SCJ and the new SCJ is called the transformation zone. Here is the original SCJ on the left and the new SCJ on the right, with the transformation zone in the middle. In the transformation zone, the columnar epithelium is being replaced by new metaplastic squamous epithelium. The transformation zone is where over 90% of squamous cell carcinomas and dysplasia occur. Here I have provided a brief summary of the main histological features of the cervix. Thank you for watching.